Hey, man. Good to see you.
Yeah.
Ready to go?
Yeah.
Ready to rock and roll?
Yeah. I got, look, I even brought a little camera.
John, we're born ready. We're born. We're born ready.
Yeah. Right? Born ready,
we're
damn right.
Together behind Mark and Ghost.
This is the New England Classic Charity Trail Ride 2019. This is a Saturday. And we naturally broke up into small groups, the crew from Connecticut. And it's Alan's leading, Johnny right in front of me, and me. And this is just the start of the ride. You're kind of sorting things out. We're in the lead groups. And there goes Johnny. Hit a rock or something that get kicked up. You can just start making your way. And as I said, things will sort themselves out, but we're riding kind of fast in the beginning, as you can see. And some slower riders, I guess, are up ahead. But it's all good. We're having a good ride so far. It's wet, very wet. But the trail seemed to be in pretty good shape at the start. Now, after 500 riders come through, the puddles that you're going to see will be, they'll swallow you up. And the mud will be almost unpassable. But here we are sorting things out. And it's an awesome day. The day's perfect. Temperature's good. You work up a sweat. There's a lot of rocks, a lot of work in your bike. Throttle control, balance, that's what it takes. There's actually an adventure bike that's stuck out here. I don't know what he was doing out here. It's no place for a heavy bike, as you can see.
Right in the fucking water.
Tip overs like this happen in the worst possible places and at the worst possible moment.
Hidden log. You gotta watch out. Uh-oh.
first puddle, I fell right down in it.
Oh, are you okay, bud?
Yeah, I just got soaked.
You want some coffee or goggles?
Yeah.
I got it right here.
I'm all right. Just my gloves soaked.
My gloves.
I'm okay.
I got totally soaked. Here for a
point. Yeah, I'm soaked. But I'm good.
All right, this is going to stop it. Oh, I forgot about the ride. There's no ride around it. Because they're not going this way, I don't think, Alan. That'll be 3 feet deep, dude.
It might be worth coming back here in a couple hours just to watch.
Just to watch from this way?
Hampshire's had a lot of rain, and it shows here. A lot of mud and debris in the water, slippery rocks, all kinds of things to set you straight.
Yeah, a lot of water in my boots.
I think this is Bear Brook Forest. It's pretty fast. Nice sweeping turns. You can really haul ass. Rev up your engine and go. A lot of fun. You can actually hear the trees whoosh by. You have to watch out for the flying rocks from the roost on the bike in front of you, which you'll see up ahead.
Ow, ow, ow!
It's painful. You're moving forward, the rocks are firing back at you at speed. They really hit your bike and hit you hard. Riding close to Johnny. Some people get unsettled when you ride too close to him. Some people don't. Johnny's a road racer. You can see a little bit of his road racing technique there as he leans around the corners. It's pretty funny. There's nothing like racing down these roads, though. At speed on a dirt bike, there's just absolutely nothing like it. If you can see, it's a real trip. You can just haul ass. And you gotta, know what you're doing. It was a rock climb after lunch. Extremely steep. Right here, not too bad, but up ahead, just extremely steep. And,
after lunch, you gotta get with it.
You know, you gotta get back up to speed after you've sat around for a while and had lunch. So here comes a real serious climb. And there's places to go around it. And I looked at it and said, shit, here we go, I'm going for it. And I make it to the top over those big rocks and make it. It's like, not bad for a 65-year-old guy.
Like that, you could smash your bike to pieces.